Yes, I hope I'm audible and welcome to the Mindstate Technologies training guys over here. And we have people are from Bangalore and I would like to introduce few things over here. And before that, I would like to confirm, am I clearly audible to you all people and the screen is visible that I share to you? Can somebody confirm me that before I start? You can just unmute and confirm me. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much for your acknowledgement. Yeah, sure. So what we are going to learn over here and what we are going to try over here. So I would like to answer those questions as well. And what is the today's session is all about, the demo session, and what is the course is all about. So the main intention that we have kept this particular course behind is that to keep the people ready for the industry directly. What does that mean with that? For example, the people who are already working in industries, in other companies, it could be MNCs, it could be startup, it could be anything, fine. So they need the people who are very much skilled, fine. You might have completed your engineering, you might have completed your MCA, you might have completed your degrees and many other educational things. But the skills that require to complete the trainings that are required to join any corporate company, or after that, any particular technology where you're going to work, and how you should talk with them, and how you should write the code, how you should manage some project, how you should manage the deadline. So these all things are very much matter over here. That is the thing here at Mindstate Technologies Bangalore. We take care of all those things so that you will be ready to face industry challenges. Fine. So you are already ready with your educational things and you are familiar with many things, but the things which are needed for the industry, whenever you face any interviews or whenever you try joining any company, what are the skill sets are required? We'll try to provide you exactly those from industry level experts only so that they can give you the best things. And coming to my introduction, so who I am to train you over here. So I'm having the experience of 4+ years of experience, and I'm a passionate corporate trainer as well as the consultant in Angular, Node.js and related technologies. So I frequently train the people across many companies, Infosys, Capgemini, TCS and many startups. So I train the people over there the way I'm training you here. I also train them on different technologies so that they can start with their projects. So you can imagine the level of training that you will also get. So you will also get an equivalent level of training with Mindstate Technologies Bangalore over here. The technologies training the people who are employer of bigger companies and MNC companies are receiving. Fine. So please try to put your 100% of in this particular training. And this training is taken care of, means a bunch of technologies are put together in this particular training. Fine. Because by picking up the exact things that are required with the current requirement in the wherever the openings are or where the company's requirement are there, by talking with them. So we have figured out some couple of things which are very much required. Fine. So out of that, one is the full stack development that we have picked up and in which we are going to train them. So it will be a bigger course in which it will have a 6-month duration. And after that, we'll complete it step by step. Okay. So the first step in that will be the front end. So I'll just try to give you an idea how exactly these all things will work. I'll just want to give you an idea over here so that you'll get to know how the things will be covered for you. I'm not a very good at drawing, but I hope you people have understood what I'm trying to say over here. Very first thing, when I'm talking about the front end and everything, so I can create the application which is applicable in my mobile. I can create some application which I can see in my laptop, which I can see in desktop and all those. It means I'm all talking about the front end. All right. So the front end technologies, for example, how to create a website, how to create a UI and many more things. All right. So this is all about the front end. We can say, for example, these all things are comes under the front end. All good. Okay. So with front end, what I all can do, I can create an application which is compatible in mobile. I can create application compatible in laptop and as well as desktop and many other things. Okay. Because when I cover all these things, maximum users can utilize my application. All right. So this is all about the front end that we are going to cover. And of course, to design this front end, what are the technologies that we are going to see that we will discuss further. One more next thing. So we also need the back end. We also need the back end. This is the second phase of the full stack development. In the back end, we are going to have some application which are related to the Node.js, Python, Java. So here we can create the back end. Of course, the backend also can be created in many other languages, fine. So the backend languages, which are mostly used by the industry and which are currently requirement in this particular 1 year or 2 year, we have picked up that particular languages only for backend as well, so that it will help you more and more and keep you industry ready. Okay, so this is all about the backend, and the backend can be done in Java, Python, Node.js, and many more similar technologies. Fine, our team will periodically keep informing you about these things. What are the upcoming tasks are there in this particular training? What are the upcoming phases are there in this particular training? All right, okay. What is the next stage? The next stage will be the database. Coming to the database, when you're talking about, so this is all about the database, and we are going to try some database with MongoDB, MySQL, Oracle, and all. Fine. So of course, how exactly these all things combine work together? So if you understand about the full stack, so it's interesting very. So when we talk about the full stack, so you can imagine there are a couple of things are different things we can say. For example, the front end, the back end, and the database. So whenever you will start working as a full stack development, so you should have understanding in all these technologies. And that is what the full stack developer called. So you might have heard about something, a front end developer. Okay, so the front end developer. So what are the technologies in front end? So in front end, I can say the Angular is there, React is there, HTML, CSS, JavaScript. These are all about the front end. All right, I'll just make a note over here. For example, I'm talking about the Angular over here. Okay. So the front-end application, I can create in Angular. I can design my page. I can design my website in the front-end technologies. And we are going to use over here Angular. And I'm the trainer who will be responsible to you to understand, to keep you understand all these things which comes under the front-end development, these things. All right, guys. So in this particular first phase of training, we will discuss about these front-end technologies. And we are going to discuss more and more in detail about Angular. All right. And whatever discussion will happen in this particular angle, whatever the training will have, of course, it will have some course project with you so that you can create some course project. And I would also like to highlight you a few things. So what exactly the course project and what are the things that can be done once this is done? Okay. All right. So you can see here. So this is a basic website. This is a basic website that I have created with Angular. And this is all about, I'm talking about the front end. Right? There is no linking between the backend. There is no linking of the database over here. We are just talking about how we can create a more and more good front-end application. All about that. Okay. So when I'm saying this is a front-end application, I'm able to see a menu. I'm able to see a list of posts. I'm able to see some options over here, which will have something like this. All right. Okay. So this is perfectly visible in my laptop. All right. I'll open the same in my mobile. So I can see something like this. Okay. So I'm able to see the same website in a very perfect manner in my mobile as well. Okay. I'll try to open the menu. All right. Yes, I'm getting it very clearly here. It's all good, right? So my application is perfectly visible in laptop as well as mobile, as well as in desktop in bigger screen. Even if I reduce my screen size, it is good. Even if it is I increase my screen size, then also it is good only. It is not having a bad behavior when I'm displaying it in various different screen sizes. That time also is working very well. And after that, this is all about, I'm talking about a small application. So do I need any advanced framework over here? No, I can create with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. For example, the websites which are very simple. So we can make use of, for example, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So these are the basic building blocks, we can say, fine. So whenever we are talking about a simple website, we can go ahead with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. There is nothing bigger framework which is necessary for the websites like this. All right. But what about this? All right. So this is something, what a bigger application. It is having some graph. It is having some more and more options. It is having some options to customize the website as well, and many more things. All right. Okay. So this is something, what a more complex website. It is having few more options to manage all the members. It is displaying the data in a table in very well format. It is also having some other option to export the data into Excel, and many more things are available. All right. So the intention here with this particular website is that we cannot always complete our website work, the front end work, only with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Only with this, all the things cannot be completed because these are the basic things. Of course, you can do this, but if you try creating the same thing in here, you can do that, but it will take you months of time to do that. And it will be very difficult if you start creating in that only HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So there is an exact requirement start. There is an exact requirement start for advanced frameworks. So this is all about the Angular. So what exactly the Angular over here? So we'll understand the definition. We'll understand the meaning of Angular. We can create a website in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Okay, no problem. But when you want to create a bigger website, something like this, so we are going to use Angular framework. So what is Angular framework? Angular framework is a framework in which HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, these 3 to 4 things are combined together very well so that we can create a bigger application, something like this, very well. It is just a framework which helps us to create a website in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and similar technologies in background. It is just a framework. It is not a programming language. It is not a platform or something. It is a framework which is allowing us to create a bigger applications very easily. That's it. Nothing special about the Angular, like it's a language or something. But understanding that framework, how to create these websites and everything, is more important. Fine. So this is all about the Angular, guys. Okay. I just tried to give you an idea about what exactly the full stack development will be, and if we are at which particular stage in that, we are at particular which phase in that, and what we are going to cover, and what exactly the Angular is. Fine. So if anyone having any questions in your mind, I'll just take a pause for 30 seconds over here, guys. So feel free to ask me that any questions in your mind about the Angular or about the full stack development. If any more questions apart from this you're having, you can ask it at the end of the session. But anything related to the full stack that we have seen here and related to the front end that we have seen over here. Because if you are very clear with that, we'll move ahead with what exactly the Angular and what are the building blocks in Angular, how we can start creating the application in Angular. A quick demo we'll have. And if you are clear with all the concepts till now, please drop your confirmation in chat box that you are clear everything and we can go ahead to the next. I'll wait for your replies for 30 seconds. And your questions as well.
I didn't understand what you say. Kindly say one more.
Yeah. Yes, Vasant. So what I'm saying that, so we are going to create some application over here by using Angular, right? So what exactly okay. The Angular is, and after that, how exactly this full stack development stack works. For example, what is front end, what's back end, and what is database? So we have discussed about this. If you are having any questions on that, feel free to ask so that I can clear it more before I start showing you how exactly the Angular works.
Okay. I understand.
Yeah. If people, you are clear with that, please drop your confirmation in chat box that you're clear so that I can proceed with the next one. Yeah, I'm getting few confirmations. I'm waiting for the confirmations from other people as well. I got the confirmation from Praniti. Please keep dropping your confirmation in chat box that you're clear or not so that I can move to the next one. Yeah, looks like everything is clear for you people. That's perfect. And we'll start understanding how exactly the Angular works now. Coming to the Angular introduction over here. So I'll just turn on my slides over here to give you more good understanding about Angular. So we have seen what exactly the Angular is and how exactly it will work. Fine. So after that, what are the versions in Angular? For example, when we are talking about the Angular versions, give me a second. Let me just turn on my slide over here. Yeah, I hope my screen is visible. So when we are talking about Angular, so we have seen what exactly the Angular is. Angular is a framework which combines different things and where we can do our work. All right. So what next? So coming to the Angular, there are a couple of versions of Angular. For example, you might have heard about AngularJS many times. AngularJS, and after that, Angular version 2, Angular version 3, 5, 6, 7, and many other. And recent one is Angular version 12. And version 12 is got just got
Angular is a TypeScript.
Angular comes over here. So how we should proceed with that? So for that, I'll give you one small description about that. So whenever a new version of Angular comes, so it will not have any bigger changes from the developer perspective. So why then there is a new version after every 6 months then by the Angular? So when I'm talking about Angular is a framework, and we have seen that it is connected with various technologies like HTML, CSS, and many more we have talked just now, right? So definitely when it is connected with different technologies, so whenever a change will happen in any technology, whenever a change in happen any technology, whenever any update will happen any technology, so Angular need to update itself. Angular need to update itself so that it can perform well from the security perspective, from the performance perspective. All right. For example, there is a new version in HTML. Angular will update itself. There is a new version of CSS. Angular need to update itself. All right, because Angular is connected with these technologies. So definitely whenever a new release is coming for any technology, so you have to update the Angular as well. So that is the reason after every 6 months, there is a new release of Angular version. And we should not worry about the Angular versions and why there is no need to worry about Angular version. For example, I'll tell you, if you are familiar with Angular version 2, so with Angular version 3, 4, something up to till now, version 12, there is no difference there. Then what are the differences between these versions? So the differences are performance level in background, the security level in background, the integration level in background. That is the compiler level changes only that are not for the developer level. For developer level, there will be very few changes that you can count on your fingers. Fine. So there is no need to worry about that. Something if you are learning Angular version 12 now, after 6 months, there will be again version 13. Then you should again learn version 13. This is not something like that. If you have learned version 2 as well, you can even start writing an application in Angular version 12. There will be no difficulties you will face in that because there are no changes, almost no changes for the developer perspective. All are compiler level changes. This is all about the Angular version. And as we have discussed, Angular first version is known as AngularJS. This one, okay? This is known as first version and this is with the name AngularJS. But from version 2 onwards, Angular started using a very different architecture. So from that time, it renamed itself. It is not AngularJS, it is just Angular. So that is the reason you might have seen Angular version 2, version 3, version 4. It is not something like that, AngularJS version 2, AngularJS version 3. So AngularJS was the version 1 and rest all the new are from version 2 onwards are just called as Angular. And from version 1, it was using JavaScript. That is the reason the name was kept like AngularJS. And from version 2 onwards, it started using TypeScript. So what is exactly that TypeScript and everything? We'll see in upcoming sessions, but this is all about the versions. And I hope you people are clear on that. Next. So we have seen a different name over here, TypeScript. Okay, fine. So before understanding the TypeScript, I would like to give you an idea. Okay, so we'll see the website again and we'll try to understand more things. Give me a second. Let me just open the website. Okay, when I'm talking about this website, let's consider the small website, this one only, okay? When I'm talking about this website, to display this heading, this passage, this image, generally what we need HTML, right, to display this thing. All right, after that, to display some effects, for example, this heading, are you able to see the header, are you able to get in background back color black? All right, after that, are you able to see one more menu over here, which is something like this, more stylish, a black color background? Okay, so this is not an HTML, this is CSS, because to apply some coloring, to apply some animation, but what you need the CSS. Okay, so this is the second thing I have observed. First one, the HTML, so that I can display the different things like heading, passage, image, and more things. So if you want to display something on your website, you need HTML. If you want to color up something, if you want to animate something, you need CSS. And after that, one more thing you will need. What is that? For example, if there is an application, something like this, a small page, and here we are, for example, writing some data, when we are clicking on the save button over here, and when you click cancel save, so whatever the data you have added over here, so you need to gather this data, right? You need to pick up this data, and then you need to save it somewhere. So for that, you need to write some code. A small code will be needed, some script will be needed. So that is the reason we need JavaScript. So total three things: HTML to display something, CSS to color up something, animate something, and JavaScript so that we can perform some logical operation. All right, guys. So these three things are necessary for a website to work correctly from the front-end perspective. This is all good. Then what exactly this TypeScript is? Okay, then what exactly this TypeScript is? If we are talking about only HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So TypeScript is the superset of JavaScript. Instead of JavaScript, we are using TypeScript. And why? There are some couple of reasons for that. What are the couple of reasons? For example, from the performance perspective, from the easy usability, from the developer perspective, and many more things are there that we can get to know. The way we move forward, we can get to know more and more things on that. Fine. What is, how exactly the TypeScript differ from the JavaScript and why it is used instead of JavaScript. But the main thing that I have told you, three things you should consider: HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And I have told you why they use being used and what are their use cases in each and every scenario. And instead of JavaScript, why we are using the TypeScript? Because TypeScript is having certain advantages to create the bigger application. That is the reason we are moving ahead with that. All right. After that, let's try to understand more things about the Angular. So when we are talking about Angular, so complete Angular application is divided into components. So why it is getting divided into components? To make the development simpler. To make the development simpler in the sense, for example, you can imagine a bigger website, something like this. Okay. So all the things that you're able to see here, this 13 active members, zero plan expiries, and this some pending collection over here, graph and everything. So all these things are, we can say here, components. Fine. So how many components are there here on screen? We are able to see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Before the graph, 5. With graph, 1, 2, 3. Again, 3. So whatever you are able to see, some separate segments over here. So these are all called our components. If you want to display anything, a part of your website, so you need to create a component. So what is the advantage of that? The advantage of that, you divide your complete website in components. So what can happen? Multiple people can work on different components simultaneously. All right. So multiple people, when working on different components, those are not interconnected with each other. All are separate. For example, you have divided your website in 100 components. Any one of the component is not working properly, but your website will work correctly, right? Rest of the website, 99 component will work correctly. Only one of the component is failing. There could be some problem, something. You can rectify that. But this will be the advantage. When you're dividing your complete website in components and some things are failing, all rest things will be correctly working. So this, you can say, this will be few advantages when you divide your website in components. So all right, we have understood one thing. Our website is divided in components. So let's example, this is also our website. So on top of, we are able to see some heading with black background or the menu. That is my header component, I can say. After that, I'm displaying some data. That is my second component, I can say. I'm clicking on login option. This is my third component, I can say. When I'm clicking on edit option, this I can say my next component. All right, everyone. So here we are dividing our website in multiple components. What is first component? The head, the menu one. What is second component? This one. What is third component? This post list. What is my next component? This one. Getting, so whatever we are able to see on our website, we are dividing everything in components so that we can start working on that. And each and every component, for example, I'm talking about this component. Each and every component will have separate HTML file, a separate CSS file, and a separate TypeScript file. So why separate? In this component, what I want to display, that I will write in HTML. In this component, what animation I want to do, what coloring I want to do, that I will specify in CSS. In this component, what code I want to write, that I will specify separately. So each and every component will have three different files with that: HTML, CSS, and TypeScript. And we'll see a quick code about that as well. Give me a second. Let me just open one of the example for this example project. Let me open one of the sample project that I can show you for understanding. Give me a second, guys. Let me open the perfect project for you so that I can show you a good example. Yeah, all right, I got it almost. Yeah. So this is the project for the same that you're able to see the output over here, fine. So when I'm talking about, there will be different components and everything. So I would just like to confirm you in code as well, how exactly it will be. So the code might look something different here and the code might look complex over here, but there is nothing, something like that I'll show you. It's how simple it is. For example, when I talking about, every component will having its own CSS, own HTML, and own TypeScript. For example, let's consider about this login component, auth component. So this is a component, all right. I'll confirm in code. Are you getting one folder over here with auth? All right. I said you like a separate HTML file to write this, a separate CSS to color up this, and a separate TypeScript file to perform some logical operation like getting the ID, password, and giving it to database and everything. All right, I'll show you that as well. Let's see. I'm opening this. Are you able to see a separate CSS file? All right, a separate HTML file. No need to worry about what exactly the code is written over here. I just wanted to show you a component will have CSS, HTML, and TypeScript. No need to worry about this code. This code will be auto-generated, most of the everything. We just need to understand how it works for now, okay? So a component will have separate CSS, separate HTML, and a separate types file. This is all about to understand this, how exactly Angular completely divide your website in components and how each and every component will be designed by using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, okay? So this is all about a quick introduction about Angular and how exactly it divides in components and everything. What we can say, the versions in Angular and everything. I would like to have any questions from you people. I'll just take a quick pause for 30 seconds and I'll wait for your questions. If you are having any questions in your mind till now about Angular. Or any confusion in your mind with whatever we have seen, how exactly this will work, or about the front end and the Angular TypeScript, anything else. I'll wait for your questions for 30 seconds. If you're clear with all the things, please keep dropping your confirmation so that it will be a good acknowledgement for me as well. Proceed further. Yeah, I'm getting some acknowledgements in chat box. Okay, all good. It seems like many people are comfortable now with this. So we'll move forward with one of the next thing with Angular. So with Angular, how it simplifies the development, that we will discuss. So we are not going to discuss more about the detailed idea about the Angular because that might confuse you right now, right? So we'll just try understanding the higher level view. So when we are talking about a bigger websites, something like this, okay. So in this website, you can imagine about the development. You can imagine about the testing. You can imagine about the next release and the further updates. So whenever you create a bigger website, so creating a bigger website is not a bigger job. Creating a bigger website, the main task will be to maintain it correctly, to keep updating that website correctly, to test that website correctly. So these are the main, what we can say, the focus areas will be there with any bigger website. and how you can cover up those things. So when we are talking about Angular, so when we are saying that in Angular, each and everything is divided in components. So you can imagine, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the 5 components, okay? So I want to add a new feature. What I need to do? I just need to create a new component. Do I need to touch my entire website? No. Will it my entire website and other things will get reflected over here? No. I just need to add a new component over here, which will be a new feature to my website, and that is completely independent. So you can imagine in a bigger website, something like this, nothing is getting affected whenever you are adding a new feature. So how much simple it is to create the application and keep updating your application. All right. Okay. So this is all about updating an application. After that, coming to the testing, one of the important part. So whenever somebody will test your application, a tester will test your application that you have created. So when everything is divided in components over here, so it will be easy for them as well, right, to test. Is it correct? It will be very easy for them also to test. So to test a particular component is working or not, and the next component and the next component. So it is very simple from the tester perspective as well to test it. And even if you have added a new component, so he just need to test a new component, not the rest, everything. Fine. So this is all about, it will simplify work for the tester as well. After that, you might have heard about sometimes a website crashes or something have happened with bigger companies as well. So what could be the reason behind that? For example, a part of your website is not working. For example, in our application, this particular graph is not working properly. Will it affect my application? No, only this particular graph component will have the problem. Rest, all the component will work function properly because everything is independent over here. All right, only this component will have effect and it will stop working if it is having some problem. So it can, stop the complete, the downtime. We can stop the complete downtime of our website due to a small issue as well. And this is very important when you're keeping your application live in industries. If you're just building a normal application, a blogging level application or something, that time it is fine. Even if it is down for some time, nobody will care. But when it will be a live application being used by thousands of people, so even if it is down for 1 hour also, it will be a very big issue for the users and for many commercial things. Fine. So that is the reason Angular is also a booming technology. That is the reason like everything is independent. You can develop the things faster. You can test up the things faster. And even if some of the things are not working, it will not affect the entire application. Fine. And I'll make sure that all these things will be covered to you very smoothly and you should not have any difficulties in that. Fine. And this is all about the training that you're going to have in first phase of Angular from your full stack development course. Fine. So this is all about the training. So any questions, guys, in your mind about this till now? Anything about the we have seen in the demo or anything about the training or any other question?
This job is related to full of trading only, yeah?
Sorry.
This job is based on fully trading only, yeah?
Okay, so here my job will be to train you in Angular. There are maybe some other program plans maybe allocated to you, and that will be periodically communicated to you by Mindstay. You may receive the emails or the notification from Mindstay, and here I will be responsible for the Angular training. And apart from the Angular training, what are the other activities are planned for you? You will receive a periodic communication from Mindstay.
Okay.
Yeah. Are you wasn't clear with the idea about the Angular? Or any difficulties in that?
No. Once I do a job, I learn to how work it. Yes.
Okay. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah. Other people, any more questions about whatever we have discussed till now? I'd like to hear questions from you people if you are having. Yeah, let me check here. Srinivas is there. Srinivas, are you there online? Srinivas, we're not able to hear you clearly. Srinivas, are you there? No, maybe there is some network gap. No problem, Shinas. We are not able to hear you. But I'm done from my side, everyone. So if you are having any more confusions or any more doubts with you, so you can just contact the Mindstay over here. If you are having any more issues apart from this as well, and if you are having right now also, you can ask me. And if you are not having any questions, so we'll move forward with the training of Angular. And I can acknowledge you one thing over here. I can guarantee you hear you one thing. Once you started learning the Angular, so at the learning stage, it will be a bit complex, we can say. But once you have understand how exactly the Angular works, it will help you to create any bigger application. That I can say. When you start learning any other,
bro, okay. If, bro, once I'm joining this job, means I invest any amount in this.
Sorry, Vasan.
If I join in this job, means if I want to invest in this.
The Mindstay will be the correct way, means correct person to answer you here, because I am the trainer regarding this training program only. So I'll ask to contact you. I'll just forward your name so that the people can contact you. Okay, because my team can answer you better. I am the trainer over here for Angular for that. Okay. Yeah, is that
hello, okay, sir, can you audible?
Yes, Vasan. So what is I have got your question, but person to answer that, because I'm a technician over here. So I'll just forward your name so that my team can let you know about that. Okay. Yeah, sure. So let me just confirm with Srinivas one more time, just a second.
Hello, sir. Can you
No, I think Srinivas is having some network issues. No problem, guys. So any more questions if you're having, you will receive a periodic communication from Mindstay. And I hope you have received a very good understanding about the Angular, how exactly it works. Okay, fine. So for now, we'll just close the meeting over here. If you are not having any questions, and we'll see in the training, once the training starts for you, and the communication will be given to you as soon as possible. Is that fine? Thank you so much, everyone, for joining. Have a great day with you and stay safe. Take care.